You know, viewers, though, these computers are pretty much optimal now. This old XP computer, I've done a couple of more mods. Put a case mounted PCI slot mount and converted to a front mount. Two USB ports now, it's got at the front. Works quite well now. That's the old XP computer. So that's one. And I got another one. I managed to get it working on this one. And lo and behold, I managed to get a graphics card to work on this thing. A GT, the other 8800 GTs in there. For some reason, it's not crashing or anything, or not being unstable. It actually bloody supports it. This motherboard actually supported this graphics card quite well. I don't believe it. There you go, an 8800 GT on a server board. Did some benchmark tests, and sure enough, no crashes or freeze up or lockups. It's running fine. Unbelievably. It's actually quite a good machine now. That was the only thing that was letting it down. I was going to put Windows 7 on here again, but I'll have to reactivate it again. So I just bit the bullet and put XP Home Edition on here, and it activated quite well. XP are probably, I was going to put Windows 7 on it, but it would run good with that. Better off with that, but nah, I put XP in it. To see if it would run it any better. I left the other Kingston SSD in here. It's actually quite a nice little performer. I've got another computer now. The USB speaker thing's alright than that. Unless the sound card would be better, so I don't have to have as much taking up the USB ports, but that works pretty good. I don't believe it. It actually works quite well on a bloody graphics card. Surprisingly. Anyway. Viewers, this server-ish PC is actually working out quite well. Took the tape drive out, put that away, because I haven't got any drivers or anything for it. So put the DVD drive up there. With an SSD, it's actually not too bad. Probably not quite as fast boot up as a Windows 7 computer, but still pretty good. I'll see what the NVIDIA graphics driver spec says about this rig. A benchmark score. Let's see what it scores out at. I want to put professional on here though. I got a copy of it, but I just cannot see how to get it to install. I had a copy given to me at school, a burnt copy, and that worked on an old computer, but I can't remember how I did it. And I got another copy of the internet, a newer version of XP Pro. But you obviously can't boot off a pirated disk for obvious reasons, but I can't remember how I got the last one to work, to install. No, it should boot up. I don't know why it's not. I don't know what's going on there, something's gone to sleep. Well, this thing was working brilliant. I had this thing benchmarked yesterday. This thing was working brilliantly, no lockups. Now you can, in certain circumstances, get a good run off a server motherboard with PCI Express graphics, but don't expect it to be a good machine. It will lock up and crash on you, so. But it's not so bad now. Yesterday it did really well. Okay, fog. There you go, it's working good now. If this proves not to crash anymore, once it's all configured, we'll see how it goes, but if it turns out to be quite good, I might put a sound card in there instead of just a USB headset, because I need all the USB ports and this thing I can get. There you go, it's a graphics card I put in it, the other one of those. Xeon, 2.4GHz, 4GB of RAM, 3.12GB usable. That's because it's a 32-bit bloody Windows. I want 64-bit. There you go. Home Edition. Over here, game optimization, GeForce 7654 series, no cards that I need, I think. This one is not supported anymore. Vista 7 or 8 I don't have, and I don't have that series card in there. Well, it's not too bad. Not supported, oh, okay. And the operating system obviously not, but the Xeon and the RAM's alright. Yeah, ah well. If I could find how to put bloody professional XP in it, it'd be nice. I would put Windows 7 on here again, but then I gotta get rid of the top and get another key to activate it again. You can hear the sound coming out of the speakers, there's some distortion. Typical. But yeah, it works quite well, no lockups. I don't know why I locked up before, but it's working fine now. Why isn't my speakers working? Yeah, it works, just not in the thing. There you go. Yeah. This one doesn't detect that's USB, but there it is. C-Media USB headphone set. I paid $2.54 on eBay. But there you go, it works. If I could put bloody professional on this, it'd be nice. But so far, this computer works quite well. For a server, you're going to have some limitations, but still pretty damn good. Anyway, that'll be enough on this one for now. I'll do one more check. Yep, I'm initial version 2002, service pack 3. I found, because XP's not supported anymore, I had to download all the updates manually. So, it's a bit of a tedious task, but I got this pretty much up to date to where I wanted it. But yeah, I want professional though, 64-bit professional, because then it will allow me to use all 4 GB of RAM and have other extra features I want to use. Yeah, 3.1 gigabyte of RAM, Xeon dual core 2.4 GHz, X3220. So the Xeon's actually quite a good CPU. They're expensive too, so it's an LGA 775 socket, so. The RAM in this thing is specific to that CPU for server purposes only, so I can't really put any old RAM in this. So it has to be server specific RAM that this needs to run. The chipsets on the server would it's good for some things, but has other limitations to a high-end gaming PC. So, but for a server board, it's actually not too bad. Designed to run off as 2007-2003, so it's 2007 era this was made. There you go. Yeah, see, the Ethernet driver on board, Ethernet driver after, because I don't have a driver set with that motherboard, I'm going to have to install everything for the chipsets on this board manually. I don't know if I'll look online, but we'll see what it does. Anyway, working quite well. Only been off for now. Thanks for watching.